Okay, guys. Next matchup coming on our feature table here at the Joint AQ for the 48th annual Terry Stonier event. We have a little treat, actually. It's a treat to me because John Henderson is coming to play in a match now, and we had the opportunity to stream John Henderson in a James Botch's 10-foot one-pocket challenge a couple weeks ago, and he won. He came down from Northern California, drove down to the Botch residence in El Segundo. He played a four-man tournament on this 10-foot table, and he won. He won the whole thing, won $1,000, and he sent everybody else home with no bus fare. So John Henderson is going to be playing a guy I don't know. I believe he's friends with Vilmos Foldish, and I believe he's Hungarian, and his first name I believe is Zoltán, and I'm trying to get more information on him. But one thing's for sure, if he's a friend of Vilmos's, this could get interesting. Vilmos actually brought another friend with him a couple years ago to California, Attila Beshdan, and Attila Beshdan won in the Top Gun Mez Weste Tour event when they started in their first season 3 years ago. He won the Top Gun event beating Oscar Dominguez in the finals. And that was one of Vilmos's friends, and Zoltán is another of Vilmos's friends, so who knows? I have no idea what to expect right now. But John Henderson has a little bit of flair that we all like. We love John Henderson. Well, thank you, Brent Peterson in the chat room. Thank you for your kind words. And thanks for watching with us. Don't think I've ever had the pleasure of seeing you in our chat room, but thank you. Thank you very much. So here we go, guys. Race to six. This is a double elimination race to six tournament on both sides. There was $1,000 added in this tournament. Not a big deal here, but the real big deal about this event is that it is it's a reunion event. Once again, it's the longest running tournament in California, and we are honored to be able to, you know, bring you coverage of this event. I can't wait for year 50, you know, the 50th anniversary. We got to come up with something special for that. Okay, Zoltán breaking. Makes two balls. And he has a shot on the one. Well, so far, that's not good news for John. To play a beautiful break and end up with a Cosmo. He's looking good. He's got kind of a compact stroke as well, like maybe one of the, like a European or a snooker kind of stroke. A little bit of movement, and he looks like he's playing with some kind of a Joss or a, maybe a Sean. I'm not sure what he's playing with. It's got a metal joint. Very nice looking cue he's got. Just as quickly as it started, it's over. The first game, 5 minutes since the coin toss. 1-0 Zoltan. Zoltan makes his first mistake. And welcome back to Aaron Moore in the audience. It's like we're having our own little reunion in the chat on our viewing audience. So, John doesn't have a clear path to a pocket with this three ball, but one pocket player that he is, golf player that he is, I'm sure he'll come up with something worthy. That's a very nice shot. I believe that's going to be a ball in hand, no rail. So John will be happy to have full control of this pattern. And the thing he wants to do is he definitely wants to close out. Doesn't want to fool around with any innings with this guy, because I can see that he knows how to play. So, cash in on those opportunities, my friend. Seven's in the pocket, no wonder. All right, I thought he just had the eight ball left on the table, but now I see why he played that six that way. You just gotta go for this, you know. I mean, he's got a tough shot, but it is makeable, and I don't think he'll scratch. Just gotta spin it in, spin it in, spin it. to win it. Nice shot. John just said, I played it as tough as I could. And this is one, another reason why we love John Henderson. He's always, you know, in good spirits, win or lose. I think he's just happy that he's playing the game, as we all should be. So, one apiece. John Henderson to break. Oh, nice, nice controlled break. That was a very good break, especially for an old school player. You don't see, you know, players that age control the break and nine ball as well as he did, but he didn't make anything. He's basically just trying to find the break, you know, so he's starting soft. It was all time playing safety here. Forgive me, guys. I'm a little stuffed up in here for some reason. John is a consummate pool player. I mean, the guy's played everything. He grew up playing snooker and golf on a 12-foot table. He still plays quite a lot of golf, even to this day. And by golf, I mean not on the green, but golf on a 12-foot snooker table. This is a tough rack to pick apart, really. I mean, this is the tester shot for him right now. Come around maybe two rails short of that three and play the three on the side. And he looks good. Looks good. He came up short of the three and play for the side. I don't think he's perfectly straight, so he may nudge this four a little bit. Gotta be careful not to nudge it too thick. If he does, he'll take away that side pocket. Yeah, he hit it thick. A little precarious here. I think that five ball takes away half the pocket that he's looking at. Just gotta be careful here. This is not straightforward. I mean, you got the six and the seven where they are, and the eight on the rail. If John can run this out, it'll be very well earned. Five ball came into play slightly. Yeah, this will be very well earned. Okay, he's leaving himself the cut angle on the six. I would imagine, I mean, from where he is on the table, I would see him, some people like to spin to the bottom rail, but I don't think he'll do that here. I don't think he needs to do that here. Just hit this with a natural angle, two rails across for shape on the seven. Just like that. Well, not perfect. Not perfect. But still has a shot. And if he plays it right, he can get nice and flat on this eight ball so that he doesn't have to do anything crazy. They're playing with the red circle cue ball, so it reacts with a little bit different action than the measle ball does. Well, looky here, John plays safe. Straightforward for him. John takes the lead. It's 2-1. 2-1. Looks like John Henderson's trying to make some waves here. Watch out for that five, sir. Very nice. John's considered one of the locals here. He plays quite often in the Sacramento, the Hard Times monthly one pocket tournament, and I believe nine ball as well. I run right there. So, you know, I would assume he's probably very comfortable in this room. I mean, he like Ralph DeLoyne and so many others here are long-term regulars. So Zoltan is Zoltan's in a strange land right now. Oh, baby rattle. Straightforward shot. Those are the ones we miss. Going to get us a Coke. And John engaging in safety battle here. There's one thing that, you know, it's interesting. You know, when Vilmos brings a friend to come and play a tournament, you know, you automatically assume, uh-oh. But, you know, we got a pretty strong field up here in the North Bay area. As we do in this Southern California area as well. In fact, I know what the field would have been about 5 years ago comparatively, but now I think that North and South California are very close when it comes to the number of players and the skill level of the players. Sound of Angel Olivares. He's calling out matches. Called out Francis Rita. And we got a lot of the NorCal Pool Tour players here, including Jane Ardorque. He's here. And so is Rudy Boy Estoque. You are just joining us. This is the 48th annual Terry Stonier 9-ball reunion tournament. It's the oldest running. What is it? It's the longest running tournament in California. Longest running pool tournament, that is. Can't speak for any other tournaments. And I missed the break, so sorry about that, guys. Oh, good. We started off with a 75-player field today. Miraculously, we will break this down to 8 players by day's end. And tomorrow we will start probably around 10 or 11 in the morning. And we'll start having our first match of tomorrow's 8-man field of finalists. Zoltan returns the favor, and John will gracefully accept. Or will he? Let's see. Can he make this 9-ball? Kind of a tester shot, but still, I'm sure he's grateful to be shooting it. Maybe it's that pocket. Is that pocket moving on these players? Thank you, sir.
That's a good thing about cans.
Yeah, you can put them in your pocket.
Forth on this rack, or not? No, I mean a little. Sorry, looking at the other table. So Mark Thomas is here at the Golden Q. He's doing tips and Q repair. So if you do come by the Jointed Q today or tomorrow, you can get some quick work done on your shaft or your tip. Not sure if he does leather or wraps or anything like that, but... you know, come on down to the Jointed Q over here on Fruit Ridge.
Thank you.
Okay. I just watched that shot by Zoltan. He might have a little bit of a hitch in his stroke, or like he moves his, maybe he moves his, drops his shoulder a little. I have the tendency to do that too. Screw follow. This will put John Henderson in the lead. Wow. Put some authority on that ball. I'm thinking about playing this rail first. Oh, a little harder, and it would have gone right in the corner. Maybe it wouldn't have passed the six, would it? Well, this ball's kind of safe then, isn't it? Actually, this is a little tough. John's gonna have to play something good here. One ball's like kind of frozen to the six, it looks like. I don't think he can roll it ahead of the six and, you know, try to hook him on it. I don't think that's, let's see what he's doing. Oh, now that's just too smart, sir. Jeremiah Shield says he's here for 9 hours. Right on, sir. Here's John making fun of himself again. Eek, in the drink. All right. Oh, I'm sorry, guys. The score's 3-3. So, chance for Zoltan to bring it a little closer, but he's got to run these out. So let's see how he does. How you doing, Geraldine?
Good.
Geraldine's here with us. And by the way, I would like to say to my beloved Geraldine, happy 3-year anniversary. I love you.
Happy 3 years.
Years ago today, we were streaming the Andy Mercer tournament together. We've been friends for about 3 years, weren't we?
Before that?
Yeah.
Yeah, like two years.
2-3 years, mm-hmm. Yeah. But we went to the Rum Runner, and that's where the magic happened.
Crickets.
Sound of crickets.
You know, I was expecting a little more from Zoltan before we got here yesterday. We were told that he's a pretty good player, which I don't doubt. Like, he's a decent player, right? But I was thinking that, I don't know, maybe it's this odd mentality of, like, he came all the way from Europe, so he's like a super road player or something.
Well, yeah, it's mythical because also, remember Vilmos's last friend that came out from Hungary? Yeah. And he ended up beating, Oscar Dominguez in the Mez West State Tour thing, Top Gun.
Especially, you have a name like Zoltan.
Oh, I know. It's like a superhero.
Yeah.
But, he just might be kind of waking up a little bit. Maybe he's,
jet lagged.
He might be jet lagged. He might just have some jitters, first match jitters for him. That happens, even the best of them. And John's no slouch,
Oh, no, I'm not saying John is. I don't know. I guess I just figured Zoltan sounds like Zoltar the Great and...
Zoltan the Destroyer.
Or something. You can't get past the 7, can he? Zoltan pushes. John gives it back to him.
Thank you. Yeah, good. We got coffee. Doing good? Maybe some coffee later.
Creamer, and she doesn't need
okay. Angel is offering us anything we want to drink. That's great. He's such a lovely guy.
You know, I get why pool halls have like smaller cups of coffee, right? And I guess people like to have hot coffee and you know, end up paying for a refill, what have you. I'd rather pay more money to get like a bigger cup of coffee.
Yeah, but it comes down, I mean, okay. Just kind of taking away from the pool vibe right now, aren't you?
No, that's a part of the pool hall lifestyle.
Well, you know, the first thing you want to be able to do is to open up your little pool room. And when seven customers want seven cups of coffee, you got to keep those cups small so that you don't run out of the first pot. So at least they're getting something.
Yeah.
Okay, number four, Dwayne Grimes, Andy Lacy on table four. Grimes and Lacy.
Grimes and Lacy. It's kind of like Cagney and Lacy.
Grimes and Lacy.
We do have a player list on povpool.com. The players for this tournament are on the Terry Stoner real-time feed page on povpool.com. Well, John's about to tie it up. Dare I jinx him? Good work. John Henderson is keeping it close, huh?
Yes. How old are these tables?
You know, I'm not sure. Jeff Gregory told me they're Gold Crown 4s, and so that would lead me to believe they're anywhere between 10 to 20 years old. Of a spread at all. In fact, that wouldn't be a legal break in some competitions. Zoltan a lot better.
Zoltan or Zoltan?
Oh, no.
Zoltan.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you to Adam Vegg. I appreciate that because his name was written with an M on the sheet that we were given today. So thank you very much. We have corrected the score. And John has made the three ball. A and he's telling the audience that he got lucky. Welcome back, Glenn AC Henry in the chat room. AC's over in Vegas right now, sweating it out at the Rum Runner. So it looks like Sean can actually make this two ball. Boy, he did really get lucky, didn't he? Boy, if he can run these balls, he'll this will put him on the hill against Zoltan.
Why didn't you put his last name?
I just wanted to put Zoltan, that's why. Well, if you're just joining us, by the way, jump cues are not allowed. So you have to jump with your playing cue. And it does look like John will have to either masse or jump. No, straight shot. What the hell am I talking about? He is kind of on the wrong side of this ball, though. Thank you, sir. Don't even think about it.
I don't know if he really thinks about jump cues that much anyway.
Yeah, I know. I'm just playing around. Boy, that's pretty hooked. Well, he's got a one rail kick. Maybe if he plays it right, maybe his cue ball will end up behind the eight. No. Tough. It's tough to do all the work and then only to relinquish the table to your opponent. Never a good feeling.
It's not like you left him that easy on the seven, though.
No, he didn't leave him that easy, but I tell you what, most high-quality players would jump on that shot and make it. I think Zoltan has that type of potential. I can see it in his stroke, his demeanor. Mark Hang's here, right?
Yes.
Okay. There was a mini tournament last night. It was 22 players. And congratulations to Vilmos Foldish and Amar Kang. They were in the finals. And Vilmos Foldish ended up taking first place in the mini last night.
So the payouts have been posted. The 76 players, first place will get $1,600. Second place will get $1,000. Third place will get $600. Fourth place will get $500. Fifth and sixth place will get $300 apiece. Seventh through eighth will get $220 apiece. Ninth through 12th will get $120 apiece. And 13th through 16th will get $80 apiece.
Oh, there you go. Good stuff. And we didn't have an auction today.
No.
No. We missed you, Jeff Gregory.
That would actually be the Warren Hall.
snookered on this two ball. He can't see the sevens in the way.
John.
Oh, I thought he was snookered. Boy, that John, he's full of surprises, ain't he? Efren Reyes should be back in California in September or October. We're hoping Bustamante will be here as well. So September, October, we'll be expecting Efren and Boosty to be back in town.
But you never know. Maybe they'll be able to come out here in July. We can hope.
Yeah, we can always hope. Oh, John just gave Zoltan a gift. Out, it'll be our first hill-hill match of the day, of the event.
Is he going to have trouble getting on the six, though?
He could cinch it. Doesn't have to do anything crazy. Just roll it in. Play it up table for the corner, I think. No, maybe he can't. Actually, you might be right. He's got a little too much angle. Thing is he can't really reach the shot.
Play for shape.
It's a 9-foot table. Yeah, well, you'd want him to maybe draw back and hit the 9 or the 6.
Mm-hmm.
But he's having a little problem with reach, so I think he went to get another bridge attachment. Yeah, he's trying to come back, but does the six pass this 9?
I think it does. Yeah, it does.
You sure?
I think it does.
Good shot. With shape. Zoltan's a skilled player, but I can see he's either getting back into the game or he's just kind of like getting used to being here in the U.S., you know? But he's got some fundamentals. He's got some good mechanics. Okay, so hill. Here we go. All right, who do you like? Well, I bet you $1 right now.
John Henderson.
You like John? All right, I'll take Zoltan for $1. There you go. Post it up. Happy anniversary, my sweet.
Oh.
Oh, who was that the other day that said we got all lovey-dovey sometimes on the stream? And it, they were making fun of us, kind of.
Hmm. Oh.
Zoltan makes the, what is that?
Two ball.
Two ball? Yeah, scores 5-5. So, I think he didn't know if he moved his bead yet, so I went to ask him if, okay, so he just moved his bead as you guys saw. It's 5-5. We got action. I got dollar action on this match. Loving it. Nice safety. Oh, ball died, didn't it? So John can see the ball, but he's gonna have to return a good safety here. He might just try to hide behind, you know, somehow roll it slow and hide behind the eight. Or he might try to thin the ball and create some distance. He's gonna just try to use the eight, and he dropped onto it perfect. That was a sweet shot. Okay. It's like we're still going to be in safety mode. Dollar bill's starting to sweat up there, posted up on the light.
John could play a combo on the 1-9.
Yeah, you like that shit. Look at this, look at this. At that. Sweet. John says, you remember that 8-ball that I just lagged you behind? Here it is again. No good.
Ball in hand.
Yep, John's got ball in hand. Oh no, he hit it too slow. He got up saying, oh no, oh no. He babied that ball and it didn't go anywhere.
He said, I should have played safe.
Oh no. Oh man. It's like, you know, it's a kind of a heartbreaker when it's like that simple mistake that costs you a match, because obviously when it's hill. Sometimes we take shots for granted, you know? That's where the discipline comes in pool. About this shape. He just looked up to the pool gods. Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
My God. Oh, no. He's frozen on that ball. Wow.
He's not frozen, is he?
He can't cut the ball in.
No.
No, he cannot cut this ball in. this is all, this comes down to case ball.
I'll tell you, betting on John is not easy.
You want to quit?
No.
You want to go all the way?
No, I have to.
You want to double it?
Okay.
You got so much heart. All right, here goes John. Roll it in. There it goes.
Just like I tell you, honey. Roll it in. Just roll it in.
All right. What a match that was. John Henderson and Zoltan. So fear not, guys. This is a double elimination tournament. So your first round losers are still in this event. So we'll be right back with another match.